Hello and welcome back. This is Angela Higdon, College and Career Readiness Coordinator for the Napa County Office of Education. And today we're going to talk about teamwork and what the elements are that go into making an effective team. Before we get started, I want you to go ahead and take a look at a quick clip of Teamwork in Action. Many of you may have seen this movie, but we'll just show you this short clip.
Oh, I like that one. That's a good one.
It works on many levels, sir.
You guys are a bunch of suckers.
That too, sir.
Absolutely.
Hey,
stations. Stage one,
go.
Oh, no. What have I done?
Come on. Take the bait.
What happened?
What's going on?
Look at the poor
little
guy.
Is it dead?
Oh. Stage two. Go, go, go.
I will give him the kiss of life.
Oh.
Here we go. Rico.
What is all this rock and roll racket?
Oh. Is she dead?
No.
You hoodlums!
Good heavens, are you...
All right. So, whether you agree with their behavior or not, you can't deny the fact that this is really the epitome of teamwork in action. None of those characters could have done what they did without working together and having a really good plan in place to work together.
Oh, I like.
All right, so let's talk about what teamwork is. So if you look at the definition of teamwork, you might say when a group of people work together cohesively towards a common goal, creating a positive working atmosphere, and supporting each other to combine individual strengths to enhance team performance. And I think it's important to think about some key words there. Working together towards a common goal, creating a positive working atmosphere, supporting each other, looking at individual strengths and how that might enhance the team. Those are all some of the elements that we're going to talk about today. Another definition might be individual commitment to a group effort. This is what makes a team work, a company work, a society work, a civilization work. So we all have to be individually committed to what the group wants to accomplish. All right, I've got another short video for you to watch, and this is kind of some teamwork out in the wild. Right. So again, there's some perfect examples of teamwork. All of those people had to work, or all of those characters, not people, had to work together to make things work. When you saw the anteater who was being, you know, sucking up the ants, when they all got together, they were able to save that one or two ants' lives. All right, so let's talk about the five elements of an effective team. So the first one is commitment and trust. All members of your team must be fully committed to achieving the team's missions and goals. So What that means is that it's important to come together and make sure that you've outlined what your mission is, what your goals are, and that you all are equally committed to making those goals work. So one of the examples that I might use is if you're on a sports team. So say you're on the football team and your quarterback comes in and says, you know what, my best friend's on the team. I don't think I'm going to put my best foot forward tonight because I really want him to have a win. It kind of brings the rest of the team down because you realize that you don't have one of your members fully committed to what your ultimate goal is. So it's important to come together and make sure that you understand what that is. Now, that being said, what I want to make sure you understand is that many times what might happen is that you think somebody's not equally committed to the team's mission, but it's possible that they don't understand it. So that's where element number two comes in. Communication. It's important that the teams communicate. You've got to have open lines of communication, and it's got to be honest and flow between all members of the team. So if you are coming together for the first time and you're talking about your project or talking about a work situation that needs to be taken care of, it's important that you've discussed what your ultimate goal is and how you're going to meet that goal and ensure that everybody in the team does understand it. I also think it's important to remember that everybody needs to have some input. So I think we've all been on teams where one person tends to dominate the whole conversation. There's always those naturally emerging people that jump in and kind of just take over. And that's not a bad thing. That's a leadership role that they've taken on. But it's important that everybody talk. We all have those people that don't talk. And so you want to make sure you pull those people in. It's not that they necessarily don't want to be a part of the team. It's that maybe they don't know how to insert themselves into that conversation. So if you've got that person, make sure that you're working to pull them in, ask them questions, and that way you've got that equal communication happening. Element number three is the diversity of capabilities. And what this means is that everybody has strengths, everybody's got weaknesses. And so teams that possess a wide range of skills are fully equipped to meet the challenges that come ahead of them. So if you are scheduled to do a group presentation and your team came together and everybody was really good at research, but nobody was willing to get up and talk or nobody felt that public speaking was a strength, that could cause a problem because you're not going to be able to do the best presentation. So as you're coming together and as you're looking at what your goals are and communicating with each other, it's important for you to be self-aware of what your own strengths and weaknesses are and be comfortable talking about those with your team so that you can all tap into different strengths and that's going to make you more effective. The next one is adaptability. And adaptability is crucial in a team. And I think you've all seen some real examples of adaptability as we've all kind of had to go into our homes and work from home and learn from home. And so, you know, this is something where we've had to be flexible. So in the workforce, what has ended up happening is many team members are taking to technology and meeting that way. Perhaps your teachers have started meeting with you using technology. I know my own kids had group projects that they were working on when school let out. And so they're having to come together with their team while they're not in the classroom together and be able to kind of adapt to what these changing conditions are and still move the team forward. So it's important that you be able to do that. The next one is creative freedom. So if you've ever been part of a team and you put yourself out there with ideas, and somebody shoots it down, or you continually get, that's a really dumb idea, you kind of tend to shut down. You don't want to input. You don't want to give input anymore. So with creative freedom, it's important that all members feel free to think creatively, to try new things, and to fail without the fear of consequences. So you don't want to place blame. You don't want to tell somebody it's a bad idea. Because maybe it's not. Maybe it's a bad idea by itself, but if you come together and maybe add to it or tweak it just a little bit, it becomes the winning formula, to be successful. So it's important that you make sure that everybody feels safe in expressing their ideas and that they know if you choose to go with that idea and it doesn't work, that they're not going to take the blame. It's something that you as a team will work through. All right, so again, the five elements of an effective team: commitment and trust, communication, diversity of capabilities, adaptability, and creative freedom. Again, those are what's going to keep you humming along as a team. You all have heard of Steve Jobs, I'm sure, and he said great things in business are never done by one person. They're done by a team of people. It wasn't a single person that created the iPhone or the iPad. We all need to work together if we're going to be 100% as productive as we can be. So I've got another video for you to watch, and I will apologize because there are a couple of typos in this, and it's because it's a video that I actually pulled off the internet. But this is an example of teamwork. Hopefully you know about the races. Maybe some of you have been to a car race, and the pit crew is responsible for getting that car back out on the road as safely and as quickly as possible. So I want you to see their team in action. All right, so now we'll watch it again in slow motion. Okay, so as you can see by that video, it took a lot of people to make that car get back out as fast as it possibly could. If you notice, it was three people to change one tire. So they took their different areas of expertise, they all knew what their job was, and they jumped in and made it happen together. So typically, this is where we do a group activity. And so since we're not in the classroom to do this, I would encourage you to do it at home if you choose to. There's a couple of different team challenges, but this is something you could certainly do with brothers, sisters, parents. It's an escape room challenge. And I've put the puzzles into a Google document that your teachers can share with you. Again, I want you to, as you're going through this, think about the elements of an effective team and how it can go into that. If you don't want to do the escape room challenge or you don't have the ability to print the documents out, think of another teamwork challenge that you might be able to do. A jigsaw puzzle might be something that you can do. Some sort of relay race, perhaps in your backyard or something like that. There's also a cup challenge. So if you have plastic cups, rubber bands, and some string. And I'll put those instructions in there for you as well. But these are all things that you can do to practice that teamwork from home. All right, so the last thing I'm going to show you is a video of the Blue Angels. The Blue Angels, to me, are the epitome of an effective team. So I'm going to go ahead and let you watch this, and then we're going to point out some of the things that we see that might be those elements that we talked about.
Right. Got you jumping off the deck, shoveling the overdrive. I'm waiting for you, getting you down.
Okay, so let's think about those five elements for just a second. So the first one is, again, commitment and trust. I think one of the ways that you can see those people have to trust each other. They have to be committed to that, to the end goal. They're there to do a performance. And if one person is not as committed or as concentrated, then it could have some pretty disastrous effects. Communication. They are in constant communication while they're up in the sky. They have to be. Again, if you're flying that close to somebody at the rate of speed that they're flying, obviously that you got to be able to talk to each other, because if somebody is just a few inches off, they got to know. You've got to know that in order to move on. Adaptability, absolutely. Adaptability is there. Again, if you're finding out that the person that you're flying above is a few inches off, or speed has changed or something like that, you got to be able to adapt to those changes. The other thing that they face is weather. They've got to adapt to weather. Diversity of capabilities. I think you could say that there's a diversity of capabilities. Perhaps there's some of those pilots that are a little bit more stunt oriented than somebody else. So I think that definitely, as they're forming their teams, they're looking at everybody's skills and the skills that are different. And then creative freedom. I think it's difficult to see that up in the air because their routines are so planned. But I do think that probably in the planning stage, they've got to be able to keep their performances fresh. And so I'm sure that as a team, they're discussing kind of what that might look like. What could they change? What could they do better? What new stunts could they add in? So there's definitely, I think, some creative freedom that goes on there as well. All right. So my final ask of you today is to reflect a little bit on what you learned today and think about one thing in today's discussion that really stood out to you as important to your own future success. And this could be your success on your current job, your success going into your first job, your success going into college, or even just finishing out your high school career. What is something that you learned about teamwork today that could be important to your success? And then what is one thing that you learned today that you think you can begin to practice immediately? And how will you do that? Are you working to be a better communicator, maybe a better listener? What does that look like? How are you going to accomplish that? All right. Thank you so much for joining us. And we hope that you took away something that's of value today. Again, as always, these videos are here and we wish you all the best of luck. And hopefully we'll see you back in those classrooms really soon. Bye.